Hello, Scrappers. So, what I'll do today, I will remove all palladium containing elements from these boards. I bought them on auction. They are different types, 29 different boards I have like this. And what I need from these boards, what contains palladium? These blue capacitors contain palladium, they are called Bulgarian blues. These elements here contain palladium. And these brown capacitors also contain palladium. So my plan is to remove all these elements and measure them to check how much I earned, because I more or less know how much palladium is in the blue ones and the brown ones. And for these ones, you can find easily on the internet information how much palladium we have in SP5/2 or /3. Okay, let's start. I will cut them like this and quickly process these boards. Most important, cut the legs, because the legs are just extra weight, but they do not contribute to the palladium. So I will just cut them like this, cut the legs, and separate brown ones from the blue ones, because the palladium content is maybe 3 times more in the brown ones than in the blue ones. There is also some silver inside, but let's consider silver as a bonus compared to the price of the palladium nowadays. So let's start with these boards. It takes a couple of minutes to depopulate one of them, like here. Yeah, you see, small brown one. And let's now go to the blue ones. Here they are. Actually, the blue ones are much lighter than the brown ones, so you can collect really many blue capacitors, but at the end you see that weight is not that much, and the really small amount of brown ones weighs more than huge pile of these blue capacitors. They are called blue Bulgarians. Usually the bigger these capacitors are, more palladium we have, because you have two components there. You have the this package, which is blue or brown, and actually you have a small non-magnetic MLCC inside. What you need is the small MLCC inside, and the smaller is the capacitor, the more blue or brown package you have, and respectively you have less palladium, because I'll take my chisel. I really like depopulating this with my chisel. It takes literally one push. You have just to find the right corner. So it goes like this. And the palladium is inside them, so don't be afraid to break them. That's perfectly fine. Okay, these two boards are ready. And let's go to the third one. I'll just continue with the third one. So we have quite many of these SP5. They're really good. And I think in 10 of them, you can have 0.1 gram of palladium, which is quite significant content. Let me cut this. Capacitors. Sometimes when they're too small, I also use my chisel to remove them like this. And because especially the blue ones, sometimes they put them so close to the board that you can't really easily cut them like this brown one. So that's what I will do in the next probably 30 minutes. and I'm not planning to waste your time looking at me fighting with these small blue capacitors to depopulate from the boards. I'll just show you a couple of more boards that I have. They're really different types. For example, I have really easy for depopulating these ones. Look at them. They're only four capacitors, but quite big. So I'll just quickly remove them like this and put them in my pile. And this is the last one. It's smaller, but really nice brown Bulgarian capacitor. Here we go. So what is left? This gold and this gold containing chips. And I think there is some silver on top of these metal parts. But that's something I'll check later. Now the focus is on the palladium. Let's cut as many of these as possible this afternoon. It's really interesting to me because I spent for these boards at about $120. So it's interesting for me to check, can I pay back this money only from the palladium, or maybe even have some profit only from the palladium that is there. There are only two other are already cut, so I will just quickly remove these two like this. Always cut them close to the plastic, so legs are just extra weight that doesn't count because it's legs are just metal, base metal, no palladium there. And that's another example. For example, on this board, these white ones, or from the time, because it's more than 30 years old board, they're not white, they're yellowish. But in these ones, I checked one of them. You have 1 gram of ceramics. Strange color, like it's really strange ready. There is almost nothing inside. There is some copper and a really small amount of gold plating in the middle. So the effort to break these ones and take the small amount of gold that is inside, I mean, I'm not sure if it's a good idea to do it. And these ones here, I will just cut one of them to show you what they are. So these are Teslas probably. Yeah, these are Teslas, so nothing that spectacular or interesting. There are quite many, but really nothing spectacular. So let me show you a couple of more boards. I also have this kind of boards. You can see again here, you have this palladium containing elements. I will easily break them with the chisel. It takes really a second to remove it. And here you can see you have a little bit bigger blue ones. I will just cut the legs here. Yeah, these are a little bit bigger blue ones. I quickly cut them. And let's see what else we have on this board. I think this is, there is a good gold plating in these elements. I see also this transistor has a gold plating, but I will remove them. These transistors are also good, probably. Let me cut this one just to check. Not so many on these boards, but here you can see you have a good gold plating. This is a good one. I'll keep it, and but we'll depopulate rest of the stuff here on the next stage when I focus mostly on the gold, not that much on the palladium. Now I remove only the palladium containing elements. And let's continue with a couple of more. So for example, there's another board. We already looked at similar ones like this. So it's these are really easy to cut. There's so many capacitors on top of them. I'll just cut this leg to shorten it a little. And my next step in this board processing will be to remove everything that contains gold and to recover the gold, which means in this case to remove this gold plating, to remove these chips, to remove the gold containing transistors and other elements, and some of them I will process to take the gold, and some of them I will stockpile. For example, these chips, I have maybe a couple of kilograms, but to process them takes time, and I don't have this time now to burn them, to recover the precious materials inside. I have to dedicate a full day on this. I usually do this when I'm on vacation. I plan 1 or 2 days only on doing this, and I just focus on PGAs, on such this type of Russian chips, on processors and other gold containing chips and elements. So this one is ready, no more palladium left on top of it. But for some of these chips, you can see here the gold plating. So some of these are really good, and there will be a good gold yield from them. So one more board, and I'll just continue work and show you the final result. Here it is, really quickly. These are really quick. They're four really, really good quality capacitors. I cut them and that's all. No more palladium on top. We have only gold containing chips and this nice gold plating. It's really thick. When I put my finger, I feel it how thick it is. So maybe in one of my next videos, I will just cut all these swaths and process only them to check how much gold is in them, and I expect really impressive result from this, because this gold plating looks really amazing. So let's cut these four and let's meet in 10-15 minutes when I'm done with all these boards. I'll show you the final result. Okay, it took it about an hour, but I wasn't in a hurry, so that's the final result. Let's check first the blue Bulgarian capacitors. They have less palladium than the brown ones, but much more than in the modern MLCCs. So let's check 15.6 grams of blue Bulgarian capacitors. Not bad, not bad. There are quite many, but there's more than light. So next I'll check the brown ones. They are really the best Bulgarian capacitors from palladium recovery and from weight to profit perspective. So let's look at the brown ones. Okay, 27.6 grams of brown Bulgarian capacitors. And now I'll show you why yesterday I was so excited to find these huge capacitors. Because here and now I have at about 100 small Bulgarian brown capacitors. And the weight is 27 grams. And just these 8 capacitors when I put them on top, you see that these 8 capacitors increased, I will not say doubled, but significantly increased the weight. So I will learn more from these 8 capacitors than from 70 small ones. That's why they are really good, and I was so excited to find so big brown Bulgarian capacitors yesterday. Okay, so that's all for me today. Thank you.